Today we're going to talk a little bit about remote scale, which is in effect having one scale connected to the load cell or the scale, and then the other indicator working as a remote, like a scoreboard that comes in as a serial scale. Remote scale indicator gives the added capability of simple key press actions. So if you're at the remote end, you can still zero the scale or tear the scale or change the units. And I'll kind of demonstrate a little bit of that towards the end of this process. Where the scales in the remote scale tend to be most commonly used are at truck scales, where the truck comes in, but the scale house is actually a little ways away. And then the other one is if it's in a heavy production area where the scale is actually reading the weight, but the person that's actually doing the reading is in a remote location, say in an office. To set up a 480, relatively simple. You don't have to use the configuration button. You can just press the menu button, and then you want to get down to where the serial setup is. And then you want to go down into the 480. You have to go into COM port 2, and you'll set the trigger to be stream 1. It could be any of them as long as the other one is set to the same way. And then you hit your enter, and then you'll go over from COM 2, you're going to go over to the stream, and you're going to tell that stream to be the local. So this one will actually be the one that is reading the scale, and then the other one will be the one that is actually getting it remotely. Okay, so once we set this, now we can back out of this. Then this is gonna go, and then we can set the other one up by doing the same thing, only this one is gonna be the remote. So we'll go down and we'll go over to the serial side. Go down and we'll go back to COM 2. And you'll set your trigger. Your trigger was set at stream 1 on the first one, so we have to set it to the same thing on the second one. And then we go back up to the COM port and we go down to stream. And we set this one for remote. So once we set this, now we can go back out. And once it's saving, now you notice that the remote is reading what the local scale is set at. So as we adjust the weight, notice this one would be out by a truck or out in a production area. This one would actually be in a scale house or would be in a secure office. So as this one changes, so does that one. And then the other thing to note is we also get the indications that show that it's a stable scale. And if we were to tear that weight from the remote, it tears it on both. And notice now you have your net light showing up on both. Okay, so that if I increase the weight, it still reads that. So if we had a crate or box that needed to be zeroed off the scale, you can do that from the remote, and notice that it also does the local scale. And then both give you the indication that they're at zero. So if we have the scale in primary units and we want to switch to the secondary units, we can do that by pressing the units key. Notice it changes on both scales. And we go back. Now, if you were to use the print button, the print does not print on the remote scale. The only place the print would actually appear would be on the local scale. So it'd be the printer that's connected directly to the local scale. Okay, so that kind of gives you a quick rundown of how the local and the remote work. You'll know that most of our indicators, the 480, 680, 682, 720, 920, and 1280. Those indicators all have the capability of doing local and remote. If you were to do the local and the remote as a true, you could do a database, and on the 920 would require a program. On the 1280, you could do a remote database, and both scales would share that same database. To locate the setup of this, most of our indicators have local and remote in the appendix area of the manuals. And if you go to the appendix, look for local remote, and it'll give you kind of a little step-by-step process of how to do that. And that's a short lesson on local remote scales.